I see impartation. I see people moving to another level. I'm not here to preach, already God has done it. But I'm here to give you God today. We are here for God. My prayer, my cry, my heart. If that may God give you Himself. Because once you get Him, you will never be the same. Once you get Him, your story will change. I see a story changing in this place. Let us lift up our heads. There's a word Yahweh. The word Yahweh, it means I am. So when Moses approaches, become a snake and he eats all the snakes. Let me declare to you today, you are in the presence of Yahweh. You are in the presence of Yahweh. I pray that God change you today.
Yahweh, Yahweh,
you alone deserve nothing.
We are here to pray. Just open your spirit, even if you don't understand. Just open your spirit. You'll receive it.
Deserve my praise.
Yes, Lord.
You alone deserve the
when you live by this door, from zero to hero. Tell your neighbor, say neighbor. Open your spirit. The atmosphere is open. Say neighbor. You need to cut a battle in the spirit. You need to take it by force. You don't know how the witch do it when they witch you. They stand by your gates. They shame by the rules. They go in all directions. And they say you shall not prosper. You shall not get married. So as we are declaring, I don't want to play as yet. I want who are serious. Are you serious to take your blessing?
Children here.
They in the atmosphere receive your children in the name of Jesus. receiving your own in the mighty name of Jesus. That God was testifying yesterday. A lot of testimony I received. I was saying, men of God, you never see me like you just know me online. But you prophesied to me. You said, I see you in your birthday
month.
I see a double blessing. When you will receive a child and the child will be a girl. And also I see in your birthday but you will get married. And she was testifying to the glory of God on TikTok. The child is a girl and is 3 years old now. And the girl is born in the same part the mother is born. And also now she's married. Can I see single women? Yes. Imagine our God. God is amazing. God is amazing. God is amazing. Just imagine. And just watch the woman testify with us. Like she was testifying here. That the man of God says someone in prison will be released. And the same guy in prison called and said, they want to release me. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Last week, I prophesied as of last week.
Oh, one prophet had last week.
I prophesied one woman, I say, I see someone in prison.
Wow,
like I see someone in prison. Then she said, the father of my child is in prison. Then I say, I see him being released from prison. In the next 24 hours, he was released. I don't know it's been how many years, but if you know prison, you stay for some years there. But he was here on Thursday to testify for himself. He said, I was in prison, I am free now. Glory to God. Glory to God. And we also saw the hand of God, one woman with cancer. Jesus touched and healed her. Is there anything too hard for God to do? Allow me to observe the protocol, then we partake in the Holy Communion. Hallelujah. All viewers around the world, this is too much. This is too much. This is a good problem. Let me tell you, maybe you don't understand, you don't know what is a good problem. A problem is something that stresses you. But if we are saying it is a good thing that stresses you, it is like this. For example, maybe you are looking for a job and you get two jobs at the same time and you like them and you don't know which is which. I don't know which is which. Man of God, is it the one under government? Is it the one in the cupboard? I don't know which I will choose. That is a good problem. I prophesy to everyone, good problem. I say good problem. Let me talk to single women here. Not junior women, not junior women. I'm talking about senior. You, maybe you are praying for marriage. You go out. One car. A ranger. Just waiting for you. How are you, lady? You must know something. You go in town, you meet someone. How are you? I wish to get married to you. I love you. That is the kind of blessing that is coming to you today. If you've never been proposed before, I don't care today. I am coming with the anointing that forcing. I am forcing you into your marriage. have forced you. Let me tell you this. You will receive your bride price very soon. You will receive your bride price very soon. If maybe there is some cows that need to be finished, they will finish them. Hallelujah. Glory to Jesus.
Amen.
Nice to have Bafundisi today. Pastor Johane. Hallelujah. Thank you, Shumayeli. Hallelujah. Thank you so much for great fathers and mothers, sisters and brothers. It's such an honor today, my brother and my my squad is here. Hallelujah. You have first time visitors, thank you for coming. Sina babu abangehlanze, siyabonga sihlabeni. God bless you, hallelujah. You see a lot of people here, hallelujah. Thank you so much. Sina bathaba, bathaba bose. Bantu esabathala ke bini, kepha kule vikeli lockdown by fire, by force. By fire, by force. Yes, hallelujah. So thank you so much. Thank you so much, MC. Thank you so much, Melchizedek. Thank you so much for the choirs. Thank you so much. What brothers, the choir of brothers of priests, hallelujah.
Amen.
Thank you so much. I can see the fire is burning, hallelujah. Very soon we'll be turning things upside down, hallelujah. I can see and I was touched in the spirit, hallelujah. Because when I'm listening, someone listen, when I'm listening, you're talking. I'm a prophet. I don't hear your words. I'm here beyond what you are saying. Yes. So thank you so much for coming to church today. I believe I'm done. There are two items left. Then I will be done. We thank God also for everyone else, Babendonra, worker in the house of the Lord. You are a worker, maybe you are a worker, you are cleaning, you are a praise team, everything that you are doing, we really appreciate. Hallelujah. And it is very important that if you are in this church, get something to do. Because when you are doing something, you become familiar. Like everyone knows you. If we announce your marriage, everyone will attend because they know you. But if you're still sitting, we'll say someone is getting married. Me and my priest will be there, but others they won't come because they don't know you. So if you are not participating in your groups, we have junior youth participating, senior youth participate. Just imagine we maybe you are getting married. Each program they say someone will speak for the church. Now we are worried because you don't avail yourself even to one of the groups. Maybe you are a senior youth, we are looking for. Then they will say, the lead of senior will say, we don't know this one. Then we need to come and say, she was a faithful Christian. Coming to church every day. But what are you doing? She is very important.
Good.
And also take it, it's very important. If you feel in your heart that you belong here, you must get a form so that we be able to take care of you. Yes, hallelujah. Thank you so much. And it's also to see Bazaar Basabatla Batilla. God is doing amazing things in Bazaar Batilla. And we are waiting on September, we are going to start a church at Bazaar Batilla. Oh, I think you will clap your hands. I don't know if you will clap your hands. The place is too small now. So we need to evangelize and build. Yes, now when we need to accommodate, if it wasn't poorly, I say they must not come because the place is too small.
So
if I want them to come, we must build the hall. You see now. So God is good. Hallelujah. I want also to emphasize on the announcements.
Next week, Sunday,
we have a special service. Say special.
Yeah.
I won't tell you what will happen, but something. If you have an angelical clothes, just wear them. Do you know the angelical clothes? We are about to open something next week. Are you ready? So if you have white, just wear white. It is not as if you are going to change everything. It will be like this, but it will be special to us. Yes.
Amen.
If you have white, you can wait. And when I come in this altar, I will announce what will be happening this
week.
Yes, and I think it's only one person know what will happen to next week. Yes, hallelujah. Jesus has us here. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So come next week. Say come next week.
What are you doing?
So Mazala Bamechele apologize that he will just leave before the service finished. I don't know if the spirit want him to continue till we finish, but he said, man of God, I will just rush. There is something at home. But we thank God for everything that you did for the man of God. This is prayer today. This, whatever you are doing, you motivate me. You motivate me to do my ministry. Because there are sometimes it is dangerous to preach to people who don't respond. That is the love you show to the man of God. I pray that God may see your need. And may God give you whatever you need. Testimonies are your portion. Hallelujah. And also, I want to announce that end on the 31st, we are having a Holy Ghost conference here. My spiritual father will be here. We are going to have teaching from morning to evening. Sunday, morning to evening. Then Monday, it is a read dance. Ceremony. So we are going to take that holy and continue with the conference. Then Friday, on the 6th Independence September, I noticed that we have people who like music here. We have a guest that is going to teach us about music. The whole church must know about music. What is worship? What is praise? So we are going to have a session. And also, if you are doing ushering in church or a protocol, you must not miss that day. There's a guest that went to in Zimbabwe. So she will be here to teach you about how to usher, how to do protocol. And also for
junior youth,
I will be there to teach you about taking care of yourself, living the holy life. If you are a young person, you do not live before you get married.
Amen.
Are you hearing me? If you are a student, I don't expect you to have a boyfriend. You are too young to have a
boyfriend.
So I will be just pressing sharp on that. Then for seniors, Apostle Mavuso will be here to prepare you because you are born very age. Teach you how to take care of your taking care of your boyfriend, of your husband. I don't know, but he will teach you. So something will take place.
Hallelujah.
Then Saturday on the 7th, we are in the mountain. And we are starting a fasting. This fasting will break our first online prayer. It is the other week of September. When we break the fast, I'm not sure about the date, but the second, is it the 10th week of September? I don't know which Friday, what date is that? On Friday, the 10th week of September, we are going to have a prayer, all night prayer. Yeah, hallelujah. So get prepared. So get prepared. Hallelujah. I think I'm done with announcements. Hallelujah. Come here, my sister. Come here. The Lord loves you. Hallelujah. The Lord loves you. I see you crying. Things are not moving. We are livable. Live at happy. If they couldn't save me, no one will save me, but one prayer will get to come for the heart. Just watch. Today we are here to deal with serious cases here. Today, no, you know, in the next 10 minutes I'll be prophesying fire here. Yesterday Sister Pinin went to what Jesus said. God was doing amazing things. Amazing things. Babeshok, the bachelor team for the dead nigger, I want people the tower nigger. Bachelor was that implant was hop, hop, hop. Remember, some of them explained it. Oh, I'm explaining wrong. The chin out of it. You don't explain to me. Hallelujah. So, anyway, okay, sit down for a few minutes. I'll pray for you. I was just checking the frequency if my network is able to. Hallelujah. Because in the prophetic you must check sometimes. I want to save time today. Let's open one verse.
Luke 17, verse 18.
Why I open this verse? It's not because we are owing to open a verse. There are lots of verses that we have read here. But I open this to tell you what God says about the month of August. This is the month for all mothers. And even my biological mother is born this month. Is born this? Yes, so it is very serious to celebrate this month. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Go to the streaming and streaming on your right. Since go to streaming and right click. Where's for Zero Lord? Can you check in the background? Luke 17, verse. Can you open 16? Sorry, 16. One verse. 17:16.
Ye figa yatinanda pansi. Etinya wini da Jesu.
Give the King James there, yes.
Imbong. Imbong. Yona ke bey mum Samaria.
Okay. This was a Samaria. And he laid face downwards at Jesus' feet, taking him over and over. He was a Samaritan. It is done. Thank you so much for the reading of the word, Lord. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah.
Amen.
To bring you to the picture so that we understand.
Yes.
There were 10 lepers. In fact, Jesus went to Jerusalem. So he was passing between Samaria and Galilee. As he was approaching one home, he was not there to heal everyone, but he was going there. His mission was not to heal anyone. So as he went there, 10 lepers. Do you know what is a leper? So it's someone. If you know someone who had COVID-19. We know it very well that at that time when COVID started, they say you must not come near someone with COVID. When he cough, you will receive. So if you had leprosy, you were not supposed to come close to people. And also if you have leprosy, you were not allowed to stay with people. It simply means that leprosy was made you to be rejected. Some of us, we are rejected because we never finish school. We are rejected because we don't know our savings. We are rejected because we have been a lot in a lot. These people, they had lepers. But in that situation, they refused to stay there. Now you have a child, and the father of the child is playing with you, and you are still contending yourself in that situation. You say, I will never get married because I have a child. I will never do this because I'm too old. Is there anything to add for God? I've been disappointed. That is working. But what I like about this man, they refuse to stay in that situation. They went to Jesus and stayed far. They were far from Jesus. And listen what they did. They shouted because they were very far. They shouted because they were very far. And Jesus heard them. Maybe you'll say it's because they shouted. Jesus heard them, maybe because they shouted. No, there was something more than their shouting. I pray for someone. May God hear you in the name of Jesus. I pray for you that may you have this something more than your shouting. In other words, this statement before their shout, their faith, they waited before them. They waited before them. Jesus was not responding to their shout. Why I say that? Jesus never shouted them. When he responded, he never shouted them. Because he was not responding to the shouting. He was responding to the faith. Because you cannot have faith and not become quiet. Once you have faith, you are not quiet. When you what you have faith, you are not limited. What you have faith, you there is no one can stop you. What you have faith, you have fire in you. What you have faith, you have fire and life in you. What you have faith, you are like Jeremiah. Jeremiah said, Lord, I try to keep quiet. But I fail. When I try to keep quiet, there is fire. That is in me. In my bones. It is hot. In my bones. I try to keep quiet, but there is fire. Let me come to the name I'm about to announce. Okay, Jesus replied to them. Okay, before Jesus replied to them. These men, they want healing from Jesus. But he didn't say Jesus healed us. Jesus, this man say, Jesus have mercy on us. Is this what means to say how again?
Jesus how again?
In other words, the word mercy, it means turn to us. Look at us. Because once you look at us, you are able to see where we don't see. You are able to see deeper than the situation. You are going to see the cause of the situation. Watch what Jesus said. They didn't explain the situation. They said Jesus
said,
and Jesus never laid hands. In the prophetic house, we give instruction. Jesus gave them instruction to them. He said, go to the priest. All of you go to the priest and show yourself. That was the instruction. What instruction are you given? We said to you, we are doing prayer and fasting that you will never change. That's why your life is not moving
anymore.
When we are saying we had a prayer and fasting, do because it is an instruction. As they went on their way, they were healed. Before they reach there, I want you to agree with me. I'm about to finish. When Jesus said, go show yourself to the priest, Jesus never, can you give me 14 of the same? Jesus never told them to say, after you've been healed, come back to me. Hallelujah.
Amen.
When he saw them, he said to them, go, show yourself to the priest. And as they went, they were miraculously healed and made clean.
Amen.
Jesus never said, after he come back to me. They were all healed. But someone in that healing, he was able to hear Jesus calling him. What made you have received something from God you don't testify? But this man, there was no time for testimony, but this man fought himself back. All of them, they didn't come back. They were right because Jesus didn't say you must come back. Yes, we didn't say you must do something, but something you must learn today. Something you must learn about this man. The Bible said this man went back to Jesus. And can you open 15? As he went back to Jesus, he was was praising the Lord. He was praising the Lord. One of them, when he saw that he was healed, turned back, glorifying and praising and honoring God with a loud voice. This is what the Lord says. This is your bat. This is my bat. This is our bat for praising God. I thought you would celebrate and clap for the King of Kings. Because you don't praise him, but you praise him because there's something that he did for you. You praise him because something happened. And you just take charge and come and bring your testimony to him. So this is our part to come back to Jesus praising him. All along Jesus was faithful to you. Let us learn to praise him. We praise him through our offering. In that praise, in that offering, God is able to hear a loud voice. There are some people, you are not good in speaking, but you are good in praising God with your substance. When you give that offering, God is able to hear your heart. There are people, you are good in speaking. Yes, you are good in speaking. But when you are talking about praising God, your plans and your pattern to praise him. But God gives you a new style to praise him. Whereby, by your testimony, after you testify, you will live according to what you have testified about.
Amen.
When the Son of God set you free, you must befriend him. You are testifying about the freedom of, maybe you say, man of God prayed for me, I was not walking. But you are still walking like this. You need to show us that we have received your testimony. Show us everywhere. If maybe you fail to walk a long distance, do it because Jesus has done it for you. Let us rise in our feet and stand. I decree and I declare to everyone here. I decree and I declare to everyone here. This is your part. This is your part for you to praise the Lord. The word praise the Lord, it means lift the Lord. It means glorify the Lord. So you are going to glorify the Lord by fire, by force. You are going to glorify the Lord by your body. You are going to glorify the Lord by everything you are doing. You are going to glorify the Lord by your body. Everything you are doing, you are going to praise him, glorify him. Lift up and say, oh Lord, I make this vow. All my life, I will praise you. All my life, I will remain in your house. All my life, I will give my body as a living sacrifice. All my life, I will be faithful. All my life, I will love one another. In the name of Jesus.
All my life,
I will forgive people. I'll forgive those who do trespass for me.
I'll forgive
them. In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Thank you, Holy Ghost.
Thank you, Holy Ghost.
Let's clap and for the King of Kings. We are breaking the bread right now. A stony heart must be broken. Grudges must be broken. Anger must be broken. Some people come here and be unfaithfulness must be broken. As we are partaking in the blood and the body of Jesus, new things might begin in your life. As we are partaking, all seven of God come up front. Seven of God come up front. If you are a man of God, please come. Jesus was able to eat with his enemy, Judas. He even washed the feet. As you are partaking in this body, it's like the Lord is asking me, are you going to be able to eat with your enemies? Are you going to be able to forgive your enemies? Are you going to be able to start afresh?
Amen.
As you are partaking in the blood of Jesus, let me declare to everyone, we are eating the body of Jesus. Jesus never had skin cancer or rash or what. If he stretched the body, I decree in this body, may your body become fresh, like the body of a child. May that body give you another part of you. In the name of Jesus. May the blood of Jesus purify you in the name of Jesus. We can partake in the body of Jesus. He also took a cup. And he says, this is my father's cup. Everyone that will drink it will have eternal life. Some of you have sickness in your blood. There's an injection now. It may be cancer, HIV, what kind of sickness? Healing is taking place. As we are partaking, it is done. Okay, we are going to do it this way, everyone. Yes.
Jesus.
Because the border baptized 11 years. Because in the realm of the spirit, the border 11 years ago. But after 11 years ago, when I evil here, lay in this carriage. Yeah? I prophesy today, every, not your miscarriage financial, but you will carry something in the name of Jesus. You are carrying your job in the name of Jesus. You are carrying your marriage in the name of Jesus. You are carrying your testimony in the name of Jesus. You are carrying this in the name of Jesus. This is what the Lord says. Next year, 2025, April, every letter of the was tough. Between 17 and 18. To be specific, after lunch. I see a testimony. What is it? 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 There is someone in your life now. The blood has arrived here. The blood has arrived. Can I prophesy? Because what I would have been about that, we are lost. I'm saying, round the bed from our book. Say, I prophesy.
In my life
is a testimony. I see someone. I hope food is actually in our house. Go to such a license. Go to your shine. Go back next year. That was the two of them to go to there. I see you driving a car. I see you getting married. What was that?
Can I prophesy?
Prophesy!
What did you do?
ukuthi ukhuluma lokuhle vula
nabe baba mulo lo sithi chi lapho ukuthi uthula hi boyfriend athi kude ngathula bathi akikho lapho. So I need to pray for you, my sister.
Amen.
I see you traveling. We don't even need to have a food and share with lunch. When I'm telling you now, I'm going to pull up corner and we have us. Kube ukuthi bese kubonwe hapa ugibele izo yofuza ngashaya abantu lwandle because ebenza kakhulu uthatha wena abantu tishela kahle kahle yebo
ngiyathatha
bebe ngoba kuba futhi nje abantu bulukulu takela lokuthi kwalo and udavule lebiya kuyeva boss
amen
and itawe negative because in the rebel hey anga bakhona baphasha kabola bakhala lapha lobe khayi ha babizwe manje nje
Mali mapha
Okay, bona ukuthi uyatsenze. Wo emathathe bathwini.
So ndamtshela maphedlele maphedlele badlodini.
Sale kugena lapha sofuna sale kugena badlodini. Because of time, I need to pray for you, eh? Whatever the big group of that that do we ask, we have us. And you couldn't have a buyer that was never able to be 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 able to be